Welcome back, everyone.
Welcome back. Next episode.
Next episode.
Avidia.
Avidia's place. Here we go. You watch Dragon Prince yet, Jeff?
No.
Gotta watch it, Jeff. So good.
Did you? What do you mean yet? Like, I've never heard
I brought it up
it.
Last time we recorded together, too.
Dragon Prince?
Yeah, it's on Netflix. Netflix original. We talked about it because it's by the same writer as Avatar.
I was in a wall. That was messed up.
Yeah, seems to be a common problem. My daughter complains about that, too. It's only this portal, though. I don't know why.
We didn't talk about Avatar last time, either.
I think we did.
I'm pretty sure we didn't. Sure you're not thinking of the podcast or the countless hours you spent on your streaming and talking to other people?
I mean, it's
I'm probably
possible.
The person you interact with the least anymore because of how much stuff you got
it's
on your plate.
It's possible. But I really thought I brought this up to you because I said that I'm not sure. I could have swore I said I'm not sure if Jack's the right age for it yet. How old's Jack again?
He's like three.
Yeah.
You watched Traveler season 3 yet?
No.
Is it the end of our area?
Ooh. Yeah. It's tiny in the nether, you know, because it's 5x8.
Yeah, that makes sense.
The whole nether's only 2,500 by 2,500 total.
Yeah, that is a tiny nether. Wait, but there's nether biomes.
There is.
Is it? We haven't even explored them yet, and it's so small.
Do you want to?
At some point, yeah. I haven't seen them yet.
We don't even right play now. This game anymore.
Whoa.
He's
got a lot of beacons.
He does have a lot of beacons. He went real hard and then quit playing the game.
Oh, he quit again already?
Yeah. I haven't seen him in a while, at least. All right. Where is the villagers? I don't actually know. He's moved things around. Are they down here? Villager Trading Center. Yeah. Okay.
Wait, I don't know which one's... Okay, that's the down.
All right, okay. Jesus, these jumps.
These are some mad jumps.
So he's got a trap door.
Yeah, they're not in minecarts.
They're not. They used to be at one point, I swear. Jeez, I hate these jumps.
They do go face to face with the zombie, though. Because they will, if they drop down, that's a trap door. How are there green trapdoors? Is that a new block?
No, that's a sticky piston with a trapdoor.
On top of it?
I think so, yeah.
What does that do, though? Can we? How does it work? I don't want to break something. If you hit a button, will it, like, work and not?
So he drops it drops the guy down. We can do it quick enough that, you know, the zombie doesn't get over here.
So he drops it down a full half a block, though. Or a full block, though.
Yeah.
So it's the same concept as yours.
Yeah, like over here he doesn't have trap doors. Or I guess he does, just a different type of trap door.
Yeah, it looks like all this is trap doored. What is that sound? Oh, that's
them turning the things and touching the things.
So it's a sticky piston with a trap. I'm curious what this trap door part is for because it seems like the piston's what's doing the work. You think it's for looks?
Possibly.
He changes it up on all these guys.
Yeah. Well, he doesn't, though. They're all the same kind of trap door, except for there's just one guy over here. Or two guys. Three guys. Four, five. Okay, half of these guys.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I can't get what's in these dispensers either. That's strange. Those are dispensers behind it, right?
No, those are observers.
Oh, they're observers. They observe when he comes back up?
I don't know the point of the observer. I thought the observer was to drop people down there to see if it was empty.
Well, does he automatically potion them and apple them?
No.
Oh. Well, never mind.
That's something you have to manually do because you have to, like, you know how you got the achievement or whatever?
Right.
That improved your trade with the zombie. I mean, with the villager. It did not do anything for me.
Well, is this another lair he was planning up here? Well,
this no, that's where they would come in on the mine carts, remember? And if the spot below was empty, it would drop one in.
Okay. Okay, that's pretty damn elaborate.
See, I don't need that. I don't care about that, the top part. What I wonder, I don't know what these observers here are observing. Maybe the ones right behind the guys are also part of that drop people in here thing.
Well, so they were on the piston that pushed this half slab. I think that's all part of the dropping mechanism, if I'm
looking at it right.
So I really do think your concept, just get them out of the minecarts and have them stand like they are. I'm not sure if the trap door is meaningful or not.
Yeah, might just be for looks.
Yeah, well, looks, or maybe maybe an enemy just has a problem being on a trap door itself, or excuse me, on a piston itself when it moves up and down. But maybe putting a block there makes them like move with it easily. I don't know. Do they glitch through it when it's just a piston?
Maybe. Like, I don't think the zombie. Yeah, I wasn't sure if the trapdoor was keeping the zombie from hitting him, but I just opened the trapdoor and the villager went down and the zombie isn't hitting him, so. Huh. Yeah, maybe it just brings the guy up a little bit higher. I don't know.
He wanted to see his face.
Yeah, yeah, wants to look him right in the eyes when he does his trades.
Well, okay, it seems way more simple then.
Yeah, okay, so no minecart necessary.
But, yeah, good, that'll save us all the iron.
We need to make a sorting system. Honestly,
I mean, you're the expert at that.
Here's the thing: is I had a tutorial before, or not a tutorial, but like a working concept. I don't have that anymore.
Let's just go over to that base and grab the stuff and move it over here, right?
Yeah.
Right. I mean, we can go through the Hermitcraft portal too. That's still over there.
That's true. Brother God.
All these hallways look the same.
You know what we ought to do? Let's do a thing.
What's the thing?
Come with me. Let's go. You've never been to Patronville.
No, I have not been to Patronville. I saw that border for the first time since I've been on.
All right. It's time that you leave the Minecraft area and go into the wilds.
Oh, I don't know if I'm ready for this. The only home I've ever known.
Have you been to the inn?
Nope.
There's two inns too, by the way.
How does that exist?
That's mods.
The one for patrons, the one for us.
Yeah. Let's see. That's
the wild.
Somewhere. This is Patronville Hub.
You should turn the Twitter or the Twitch crack cam back on too.
I mean, there's really no point now. You can just join, right?
Yeah, but for the people who don't want to join, they just want to watch. They just want to spectate.
Yeah, we do have some slots open this now. The first of the month, you know, some people canceled, and there is some available slots for those out there watching. If you want to join and play, maybe we'll look at your build one day.
Are we going to see a build in particular?
We're going to see their hub, their main village. Here's their hub.
Wow. Okay. I like this.
Yeah, it's big.
This looks a little off center, but I have a feeling it's because they plan on making a few more.
I don't know.
Oh, that's trippy. It's like you go into a square and you come out of a, you know, an offset square. Whatever that is, Chinese star. I don't know.
I don't like that they have all these beacons here. Honestly, I'm not a fan of speed and jump.
Somebody's
honestly
a fan of vintage beef, though.
Yeah, there's a big vintage beef over there. There was a guy building a castle behind it, and I think he's quit the game because of
vintage beef being.
Yes, and the vintage beef ass is in his face. So this is Unityville or Patronville. They're not unified on the name. There's tons of shops, so if you need anything, there's just about everything you can imagine here. It's available.
Is this like the climbing wall?
No, this is, you know, it's just a vine farm.
Okay. I don't know if it was like a jungle gym. Was that a person?
Yeah, it was my daughter.
Oh, I didn't even see her. I saw the firework. I didn't even see her.
Flew away. Where's the post office, apparently?
Do I have mail?
Excuse
me. Do you have any mail for me? Hello, my name is Mr. Burns. I believe you have a letter for me.
I don't know how this works. Payment box, office letter, deposit box. I guess the like the mail is like delivered.
I don't have permissions to use that.
Yeah.
How sad.
I mean,
the mail needs all our help right now.
That's true. It's true. Yeah, tons of different little kiosks to buy things.
Hi, buddy.
My daughter's got a flower shop over here somewhere. Is it right here? I thought it was right here. There was a big flower above it. Now it's gone.
Where'd you go? I lost you. I was playing in the fountain.
Hunter shop. Okay, maybe I'm wrong. No, this was a flower shop.
I see somebody flying. That's not you, though.
No, I'm not flying. I walk down here.
There's a bunch of fireworks.
I'm back
above
the post office.
Dude, I got a stack of fireworks. Where'd they come from?
Who knows?
Ow.
Watch out.
I'm in the rose bush.
Bushes hurt.
It didn't even actually hurt me at all, though. That was weird.
Yeah, I don't think it does very much damage. I can't keep track of everything here, so I can't really give you a tour.
Yeah, there is a lot here. I want to go see this castle behind the beef.
Might be gone.
Oh, wow. Somebody recreated one of the end cities? Or one of the end structures?
Oh, yeah, I guess that's what it is, huh? Why are these bushes everywhere? They're awful.
Oh, no, they are pretty awful. There's turtles chilling.
There's a lot of turtles. Jesus. Oh, the jump boost ends here.
Oh, yeah. I was going to say, why can't I get over this? Sad jump boost. Oh, well. There's so many turtles.
There's an excessive number of turtles.
There's a giant portal.
Yeah, that's the portal, the entrance way to the castle. I mean, you don't go through the portal, but...
You know, when we talk about things to build,
mm-hmm.
you know, sometimes I think they're going to look like some of these things I see here.
Yeah. I'm pretty proud of my my design for the villager trader.
No, it looks good so far. I just want to make the concept actually work.
Right.
Okay, so this guy quit because vintage beef went up?
I don't know that he quit for certain, but I think he might have. Yeah. Because of... the giant beef ass in his face.
That is kind of a...
It's kind of an eyesore.
It is a little eyesore. It'd be like... Did I tell you about the argument we were having with the neighbor? Because if we didn't purchase another house, we're going to put an addition on our house.
Do what now? Sorry.
The argument we were having with our neighbor about the...
Oh, the neighbor. I thought you were talking about your tenant. No.
About the addition we were going to put on.
What's the argument?
So his argument, it's I get why, but it's part of the problems of living in the city. So we currently live in a row home. You know, you've seen it before. You know, it's houses next to each other. So we were going to build out to our lot lines. We have architecture plans for it. It's all within permitting regulations and back 20 feet from our house. And it's to the lot line. So it butts up against his house. And he basically said, no, I don't want you to do that because you take away my ability to put in windows on the side of my house.
Okay. And is that something he plans on doing?
He said in the future, if he wanted to, he would. And okay. I tried to tell him, I said, you know that those are against regulations specifically for this reason. Like you have a lot line. The reason you don't have any windows on the side of your house now and that nobody does on our block that are on the lot line is because of the fact they're not protected windows. And if you do put them in, we still have the ability to put walls in. And one day you might wake up to there just being a brick wall. And there's so many stories about this happening in D.C. and videos and people posting articles up on Popville and things like that because it's completely legal within the rights of the tenants to do. I think that's why most of the houses don't have any lot line windows. And he just did not want us to do it because of his future plans of possibly putting in windows there and that it would take that ability.
That he can't actually even do.
that he, well, I guess in theory you can do it, but it's your own
risk,
yeah, because if your neighbor does do that, which they have the right to do on their properties within the right regulations, they're not what they call a protected window.
God, I would do it out of spite now if I was you.
Well, and the funny thing is, in New York, I guess, New York City, when I start looking up lot line windows, a lot of articles about New York coming because it's the same kind of problem there. I guess if you are caught with lot line windows, the city will make you brick them up.
Oh, wow.
Because of that, whereas that doesn't seem to be the case here. You can have them, and they just might one day be opening up to a brick wall next to you because that's the risk that you run in that. So that was a little bit, and it's kind of sucks because we really like our neighbor. I understand his desire to, because he wanted us to have like a 5-foot easement still, so that you could still put in the windows and stuff, which at one point the regulation was, it didn't change anything about the windows ability still, but at one point you were only allowed to build out that with that 5-foot easement still on any additions, but they've changed it again so you can go all the way to the lot lines because the city is expanding so fast. And, you know, so it just, I get what where he's coming from. I just, and we like the guy. We didn't want to like upset him, but we were just like, I don't understand. I don't know how to have this argument right now because this is what we need. If we stay here, this is the room we need. If we just build out with that 5-foot easement, it doesn't give us physically, you can't get rooms to the side of a hallway. You don't have physical space to do that anymore.
Right. So you're not going to do it because you're moving.
Well, now we're not going to do it because we're moving. We still might do it in the future. We have the architectural plans all built up for it. We might do it in the future.
How do we do it again out of spite?
Well, I mean, I don't want to do that. But we like the guy. Like, I don't want to.
Yeah, you're moving though. Fuck him.
Still own the place.
Yeah, you ain't gonna see him no more though.
Yeah, it's
you probably get better value for your place when you're renting if you just got that extra.
And I could have understood if he was just, you know, saying like, "Please, I'd really rather you didn't." Like, you know, but he was basically saying. So the thing is, you have to give your neighbors a form to sign. So I was getting all the forms signed and getting ready to go get our permits all pulled about the work that we're gonna do. And I think he took that as that form was we had to get permission from the neighbors. That's not what it is. It's a notice of work. And if you disagree with it, you have like a 30-day time period from the time you get the notice to object. And it specifically even says on there, like, you have to object and you have to come with architectural, like, reasons and evidence on why this particular plans would be detrimental to your structure. So, I mean, it sadly would be, it would be for him an argument he would end up losing. What the hell?
Hi. Apparently this is a villager trading hall, it says. I don't see any villagers, though.
They couldn't make it in the door?
Like, it says there's a villager here.
There's villagers in here. They're in prison.
Oh, you have to go in like this?
Apparently.
What the hell?
Yeah, there's one in this one, at least.
This is weird.
This would be the worst prison ever.
Yeah, like, how are you supposed to... I guess maybe when they wake up, they're
here.
You
can go to this side? Yeah, I guess it'll look different when they're standing up.
Huh.
What is it with these trap doors on everything? They got a trap door on this crafting table?
They just really like trapdoors, you know?
This is a very strange building.
It's very tall, too. It's like, is there a second floor?
Yep,
like,
I just made it there. It looks the exact same.
More prison? Where's the door? Where's the stairs?
I don't know. I just kept wandering, and then I found stairs. There's two sets of stairs. I don't know what side you're on.
What the fuck?
The stairs to go down, too. Where are you?
I see your name now. Hold on.
I'm right by the exit.
Yeah, I'm right behind you.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, right here. The stairs right here. Downstairs, and around here is upstairs.
Oh. What's downstairs?
I don't know.
More?
I haven't gone there yet.
Chanting room? Huh. This reminds me of, like, one of those places you go...
To die?
Oh yeah, that too. But like it reminds me of like Universal Studios, like Harry Potter Land, where you'd go eat at, kind of like one of those. It wants to look like it's like rustic or something, but it's not really. I don't know how to describe what I'm feeling. Can't use my words.
I made it to a balcony. Looks like it's 3 stories tall.
Oh yeah. Wait, there's another story?
I'm on the 3rd story where there's a balcony.
Well, I found the stairs to the 3rd story.
Just run around. It's in the exact same plot as the first set of stairs, like in the same location from the 2nd floor.
This place is no, there's not. There's not. There's only down.
No, come here. Oh,
wait, no, here we go. Yeah. I found it.
Balcony.
Oh, yeah. It's a tall building. No.
They just, I feel so bad for all these people.
Oh, they've all woken up, it sounds like. So maybe we can go look at them now and actually be able to see them. What I feel bad for is people that have to live beside this giant cobble pillar. Did you see this?
No. Are you, which window are you looking out?
Come over here. You can see me.
Where's over here? Wait, here. Okay. I mean, so it's really funny because in DC, there's a lot of these old condos, or they probably used to be apartments, but now they're all condos that people buy in the Southwest area. And it's funny because they're getting more and more expensive because that Southwest waterfront area is really starting to boom right now. But they're these old buildings that were built in like the 50s and 60s that were just the stone put together. Like the outsides of them look like the old, you know, that same old apartment that you would see everywhere, like driving down the street.
I don't think there's anything in that place either. I think it's literally 1,000 stories of empty cobblestone.
I mean, you got to start somewhere, right? You got to build the building first before you can put in the apartments.
It's my understanding they've already quit playing.
Oh.
Yeah, so I don't understand this villager trading stuff. Like, that villager's so far away, I can't even interact with him. He's just over there being...
I interacted with one, but how do you know what ones have... Oh, wait, there are signs.
It does tell you up above.
Farmer, carrots... Yeah.
And this has no way of zombifying them to make the trades better either.
No, this is just like, this is the type of thing that I would have built.
A prison.
Yeah.
Jeff builds a prison.
Yep, pretty much.
I'm going to go look at the this cobble monstrosity.
Books take only what you need.
I need them all. That's her way into this cobble monstrosity.
Let's see.
I don't think there is. I see a door on the bottom floor.
I also find the entrance to that villager trading area just so weird.
I think they do that so there's no chance that zombies get in.
Yeah, there is no door down here, huh?
No, there's a ladder I can see over there.
Over
it goes down, like inside of it.
Oh wait, there's a community mine. Like, man, that giant monstrosity built on top of the mine. Structurally sound. Can I go up this way? Oh, I think I'm looping all the way up to it. Oh, I found a way in.
Okay,
I'm in.
Poly 9990s Patreon Hotel. Wonder if Poly still plays. This is a hotel.
I'm going up to the top. Taking the penthouse.
God, is there anything on any floor?
I'm looking at the wall, not up, so I can't tell you. Hold on. I turned around to go up the ladder just to tell. I'm making the promotional video for the hotel.
Huh, if you hold right click, you go faster?
On climbing a ladder?
It looks like I'm going faster.
I don't feel like I'm going faster. Let me see. Let's see if you catch up to me. Hold on. I'll just go normal. You tell me if you catch up to me.
No, I'm not catching up with up to you.
Oh, did you ever... You never got contacted about our request to stay at Taco Bell Resort, did you?
No.
What a shame.
I tried the morning that it happened, like the morning that the things went on sale. I was waiting.
And you still didn't make it. I can't get off this ladder. They did not make this tall enough to get off of this ladder.
I guess they hit the build limit.
Wait, there we go. No. I was able to shift off of out of it.
So the top floor is like in the mind of whatever. What's that movie? In the head of, I guess it's not though. Actually, not I'm up here. But there's that.
This is our pyramid from the last season.
Yeah. Being John Malkovich is the name of that movie I was thinking of. Where like he lives on like a half floor. Yeah, from up here you can't see anything. It's just an empty world down there.
Where's Beef?
You can't see him.
You can see the one next to us.
Yeah.
So this is the Cobblestone Tower Hotel. That is the Sandstone Tower.
I actually think that's Endstone.
Or Endstone, yeah. Okay.
God, this is making me feel anxious, honestly.
And then the King of the Ladder is even higher?
Is that King of the Ladder? Oh, yeah, I guess it is. Huh.
That is interesting. I wish I had an elytra to just jump off of this now, because now it's a long ways down, huh?
I have an elytra, but I'm not going to.
Too high for you.
Yeah. No, it really makes me feel nauseous just looking out those windows.
It's going down this ladder, looking straight down, makes me feel like I'm looking into one of those infinity mirrors.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I did that with a stream the other day. I pulled up my own stream on stream.
Mm-hmm.
And so it kept, and there was, you know, because of Twitch delay, it didn't instantly become like an infinity mirror. It was like a slow growth. And you could do like the wave, and like you would actually do the wave through the growth because of the Twitch delay. It was kind of cool. I got my Lego setup finally done, so I have like a whole separate desk and everything for Lego now. I think we're going too far, Jeff.
Oh, there's a tree farm down here. Yeah, there are stuff on these floors.
Is there?
Yeah, no, there's like chests and these are the not done floors.
Yeah. I don't think these are ever gonna be done floors.
Oh, wait, you could have... I was going to say you could have gotten in right here, huh? But you couldn't quite get in here.
Oh, yeah. What a tease. Yeah, this is one of the spots that they're hoping to demolish if this guy...
For the patrons, is it a free-for-all? I don't...
So, no. What happens is... Let's say you were a patron and you cancel tomorrow. Or let's just say the first of the month you cancel. So your claim stays active for another 30 days. So if this guy did cancel 1st of August, 1st of September, his claim is coming up. And what we're going to do is I'm going to get a list from Gunn, the developer, of all the claims that are up to be released. And then I'm going to hold a Storage Wars style auction.
Nice.
So we'll live stream.
But they've claimed the land that they build on.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. So no one else can just.
Just run and like take whatever spot you want, even if somebody else is building there.
Right. Right. No. People can claim their areas. What a lot of people are doing is just claiming like their chest area. And because there's a bunch of mods like Core Protect and stuff that log every action. So like every time you break a block, it's logged in an SQL database. And if someone was to grief your build, there's literally just a command to run to roll it all back. So it's for the most part completely safe either way. The reason why they're claiming their chest is just because, you know, you may not look in your chest every single day to make sure every single thing is there. So you may go a month and realize, oh shit, my diamond pick's missing or whatever. So I've seen a lot of cool builds over here. This is just the patron village. There's still tons of builds outside of this village where people have moved out. Like Manry's made a whole village of his own in a mesa, but this is where the majority of them have kind of congregated and at least set up shops and stuff. So thought maybe you should check it out.
I'm gonna file a formal complaint here.
Where at?
I've been waiting at this assistance kiosk for 30 seconds now, and then nobody's coming to help me.
Where are you at?
Ding ding! I'm right in front of you. Turn around, turn back around. Come this way. Come down the path. Walking. Left. Okay. This way.
Still no, this no, way?
Stop. Turn. Straight.
Yeah, I see.
Waiting for my assistance. Nobody's coming to help me. Formal complaints.
Assistance kiosk. Yeah, what's the deal here?
If you're gonna put out an assistance kiosk, you either need to have a closed
sign. Just be standing here.
Yeah, have a closed sign, or you need to be here at all times. Yeah. Your responsibility as the assistance kiosk creator.
Well, so I'm really tired today because put my CPAP on last night. You know, I filled up the reservoir with distilled water and everything and put it on and passed out. Got up this morning and I went, turned it off. I didn't realize I didn't get the suck on my face like I normally get. And I'm like, what the hell? And I realized it's not even on. Apparently I didn't put the reservoir all the way in last night. So I just slept with a face mask on that wasn't doing anything.
How couldn't you tell?
So it started up at first, and then I feel like the sill on the reservoir got dislodged. Because it started whenever I first went to sleep, but at some point it didn't. It wasn't working. But anyways, we should probably end this episode here. But yeah, if you guys want to join and build stuff in Patreonville, patreon.com/minecraft.
Yeah, it's actually really cool. I wouldn't be able to build to this caliber. I'd go off my own little place.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. That's what we do. Ryuski was kind of complaining the other day. He's like, why don't we do stuff at spawn anymore? Like, we used to always have like a spawn village and now we don't do that. He's like, I go to Patreon and I see all this stuff. And that's what it used to be like on the Minecraft server. And I'm like, well, I don't know. Now we are all hermits. We just run off immediately and go into the wild.
Yeah.
Anyways, well, thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.
See
you.